Started. So my name is Candace Livingston, and I work at 19 Wing Comox. I'm a PSP instructor. Today we're going to be doing Power Hour. So it's a full body focused on core and functional movement. If you guys are at home today and you want to play music or anything, feel free to play some from home. I won't be playing any here, just so you can hear me a little bit better. I'm going to go through this disclaimer with you quickly, and if you guys have any comments or questions, you can just link them below and I'll get to you after. In response to COVID-19, PSP is offering virtual fitness to Canadian Armed Force members. By using social media platforms, the virtual fitness classes are tailored to Canadian Armed Force personnel, becoming accessible to all. Participants who are not Canadian Armed Force members recognize and acknowledge that their age, health status, and physical fitness levels are unknown, and it is entirely up to each individual to access the ability to participate in this class. Since it is preferable to consult your physician before beginning an exercise program, we invite all participants who are not Canadian Armed Force members to consult the Get Active Questionnaire of the Canadian Society of Exercise Physiology and its reference document. If you experience any pain or difficulty during these exercises presented in the video, it is recommended that you stop and consult your healthcare provider. So down below, I'm gonna have the Get Active Questionnaire and the reference documents linked so you guys can grab that. And if you're a Canadian Armed Force member and something happens, make sure you fill out a CF98 right away and send it in. All right, happy Victoria Day, everyone. We're gonna get through this together. So I'm gonna do a quick 5 minute warm up with you guys, and then we're gonna do 10 exercises. We're gonna do 60 seconds on, 10 seconds off, and we're gonna do 2 rounds of that. And then after each round, we'll take a 2 minute break. So in the first round, it'll be a little bit slower because I'm going to show you how to do everything, and then I'll show you a couple modifications and progressions for each thing. And like I said, if you have any questions, you can just link them below and I'll get to you on the breaks. I think we're all ready to go. This is my husband, John. He's with me on all my workouts. Moral support. So we'll start with our warm up. We're gonna start with picking daisies. So you're just gonna come down and sweep the floor. Your foot is out and your toes are pointed up. And you're just gonna sweep. Switch feet each time. So everything in the warm up that we're doing and stretching out and working out is going to be part of our workout. We're doing all this for a purpose. All right, the next one is going to be arm circles. So we'll start with some small arm circles just out to the side, just like this. Nice and small. And from here, we'll do the same thing, but just take it backwards. Still keeping those arm circles nice and small. From here, we're gonna go into bigger arm circles. So try to bring it all the way around, going forward. Nice big arm circles. And same thing, but we're gonna go backwards. Frankenstein walks. So you're going to have one hand out, you're just going to kick your leg up, opposite hand, opposite foot. We're just going to alternate back and forth. Try to bring that foot to your hand, not your hand to your foot. A couple more. To squat openers. So you're just going to squat down nice and low. Your elbows are going to be on your knees. Try to keep that flat back. And you're just going to open up those hips. Nice and wide. If you find this too difficult, you can just do a squat and push out on your knees like this. Try to keep that back nice and flat. gonna go into some butt kicks from here. So you can start standing, just bring your foot all the way to your bum, and then you can get a little faster. So jogging on spot, keeping that heel and kicking it right up to your bum. From here, we're gonna go into high knees. I like to have my hands out in front of me. You're gonna bring one knee up and the other knee, just like this. And start off slow. Once you get the hang of it, you're just gonna go right into it. Drive those knees up. And from here, we're gonna go into jumping jacks. Seconds. All right. Perfect. So we're going to take a 10-second break. Then we're going to go into the next one. I'll go this way. All right. The next one is sit-ups. So we're going to do our sit-ups with our feet touching. That way we're not using our legs as a lever to throw ourselves forward. So we'll have our feet touching just like this. You're gonna come all the way back, hands over your head, and up through the center, and back down. Up through the center, and back down. If that's too hard for you, you can keep your feet together, if this is what you're used to, and just do a regular sit-up, just like that, and back down. All right, ready, and go. Make sure you're breathing the whole time, not holding your breath during any exercise. Reach your hands out behind you. So all of our exercises today are going to work different body parts. So we're going to do some lower body, some upper body, some core. 15 seconds left. Last one. Awesome. We'll take a 10-second break. The next one is a pike push-up. So we're going to be getting into the shoulders a little bit here today. If you've ever been to yoga and you've done a downward dog, you sort of know what's gonna happen here. So you're gonna have your hands down, your bum is gonna be up, and then you're gonna come all the way down and push yourself back up, all the way down and back up. If that's very difficult for you, you can stick to some regular push-ups, or you can do one, take a break. Two, take a break. All right? Ready? Here we go. All right, 60 seconds. And go. So you want to bring your head all the way down. Keep that back nice and flat. Elbows out. We're at 30 seconds, so you have another 30 seconds to go. To our squat jumps. So let's move these up here a little bit. Just out of the way. So for our squat jumps, everyone knows a squat down like this, and then you just add a jump. While you're doing the jump, you want to land nice and softly on your feet. You don't want to come down super hard. So it's up, soft landing, and down. I can show it to you side on. So it's up, and squat. All right. Ready? And go. If you want to use your arms, keep them out in front of you. Swing back for momentum. So sometimes when you get tired, your knees will cave in like this a little bit. You want to really keep those out to the side. And time. All right. 10-second break. We're going into lunges. Hands on your hips help a little bit, just to make sure you're not lopsided. And break. The next one is a bird dog. I'm gonna grab a drink of water because it is, inchworm. Can I grab a drink because it's so hot here?
I'll start complaining about the nice weather.
Hands up, walk your feet into your hands, but we're not going to do that just because we're on camera. We're trying to stay seen the whole time. We're going to walk out and then walk our feet back to our hands. So you're going to come all the way down. You're going to walk out, and instead of walking your feet in, you're going to walk your hands back to standing. So all the way up, hands down, walk, and back up. Just like that.
Take a step over there.
Yep.
Step over there.
Right there?
Yes.
All right. Ready? And go. So all the way up. Come down. Walk yourself up. And back up. Almost had a collision. I'm going to go this way. Take a 10-second break here. The next one, we'll need our mats for. That's good. All right, the next one is a bird dog. You're gonna come down onto your hands and knees just like this, flat back. You're gonna take your opposite hand and opposite leg. So I'm gonna start off with my right arm and my left leg. You're gonna extend them all the way out and tap in the center and extend. You're going to put those down and you're going to switch sides. So you're going to reach out with your left and your right leg, come into the center and all the way up. All right? Ready? And go. So nice reach. You're going to slowly come in and tap. Reach again and place your hand down. So make sure you have lots of control. Woo! Stabilize that core. This exercise is a lot harder than you think when you're trying to do it nice and steady, and trying not to rock your back the whole time. So, nice and steady, nice tap, and reach. Out, in, and reach. Last one. Awesome. That's time. A little break, and we're gonna go into a plank with arm raises. I'm gonna go this way. A little bit easier to see what we're doing. Yeah.
The sweat's already dripping.
I know. It's warm in here. All right. So I'll go over this one quickly for you guys. You're gonna go in a low plank for this one as well. It doesn't really work as great with a high plank, but by all means, you can do it. So you're gonna come down. into a low plank. Nice flat back. You can space your feet out if you want a little more stability. You're just gonna reach your hand out and bring it back in. Reach your opposite hand out and bring it back in. When you need a break, you can come down onto your knees for a second. And if you want a progression, you can be nice and high and extend. All right, ready? And go. So low plank, stabilize yourself, and then slowly reach out, bring your hand back in, and opposite hand reaches out. Next one, we're going to be on our backs. So we'll turn this sideways so you can see me. The next one is a bridge. So you're going to come down, just like this. Feet nice and close to your bum, so you want to bring your heels in as close as you can. You're going to then lift up your hips toward the ceiling. And then lift them even more. So you want a nice clean line, straight down here. You don't want lagging. You want it nice and flat. All right, ready? You're gonna just go up and down. So follow along with our lead. Ready, and go. So hands off to the side. Up, 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 push, push, push. Squeeze that bum. And then slowly lower down to the mat. Once you get down, you're gonna push, 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 and then slowly lower down. Squeeze that bum, squeeze, 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 and slowly lower. Back up. Everyone's doing a great job. Keep going. And back up. We have 10 seconds left. Time for one more. So we'll go all the way up. Squeeze, squeeze, squeeze. And slowly lower back down. All right, the last one is a pulse squat. So we don't need these mats. We'll chuck them off to the side. All right, so the last one, you're gonna come down into a squat and you're going to pulse just like this. If you wanna go lower, you can. If you're finding it difficult, one modification would be you could come down, pulse in a higher squat, come back out and reset for 3 seconds, 2, 1, and then back down for 5, and then reset again. If you're comfortable doing it, stay down and pulse the whole time, nice and low. All right, ready, and go. So nice and low. So you want to drive those knees out. You don't want them collapsing in. You want to keep your back nice and flat, so you don't want to be rounded like this. You want to just keep your back up nice, just like that. We're already halfway. Feeling the burn. Shake it out. All we got through the whole round. So I'll time it, and then we'll come back and do round two in just a minute. Crazy busy this morning when we went, so be aware of that. All right, our break is almost over. We just have another minute here. Then we'll get right back into it for round two. I'll quickly go over, in case people are just logging in now, I'll quickly go over the ways to do them one more time. But we'll go through this one a little bit faster. So hopefully everyone likes the modification and progressions for everything. If you have any questions or you need something modified a little bit more, you can just write me down below. I see a few people just signed on. And yeah, make sure you're going to tension, not pain. You don't want anything to hurt during this. So if you're feeling like you're going a little too far, a little too hard, just maybe back off and go at your own pace. Just a couple more seconds and we'll get into it. If you guys have any feedback or anything, just write it below. But everyone's doing great so far. If you guys like any of our videos of PSV, you can, PSV Comox, you can feel free to share them and promote us. That would be awesome. We have four instructors here. Maria, Blair, and Katie are awesome instructors too, so feel free to check out all their stuff and join in with my classes whenever you want. Well, whenever I'm here. All right, round two, same thing, 60 seconds on, 10 seconds off, 10 exercises, and then we'll have a little break at the end, and we'll do a cool down. All right, back into it. Round two, starting off with the plank side tap. So I'm gonna show you quickly what it is again, and then we'll go right into it. So same thing, nice low plank for this one. Easier with a low plank than a high plank. So nice and low, hip drop to the side, and hip drop to the side, just like that. All right. Ready, and go. I find this one easier when your feet are together, whereas the other plank that we're doing is a little bit easier when your feet are apart. It's just easier to get side to side with your feet together. But whatever's easiest for you, make sure you stick to. If you need breaks in between, make sure you take nice short breaks and then get right back into it, making sure you get a good workout. Push yourself. Once again. So like I said before, you can do your sit-ups whatever way you'd like. The ones that we like to do are when your feet are together and you come up through the center of your knees. That way it just allows you to not swing your legs and use so much momentum. So it gives you a little bit more of a core workout. All right. Ready down slowly and up slowly. So when you're going down, you don't want to just lie down. You want to roll back nice and slow and pike push-up. So we're going to go back into working those shoulders a little bit. So just like I said before, if you've been in any yoga class and you know what a downward dog is, it's the same thing. So you're just going to start in a downward dog position and do a push-up, essentially. Ready?
Alright.
So we're going to do 1 minute. Hands are shoulder width apart. Following along, just make sure that your shoulders are in line and your head's not really far over like this. You want to keep your head behind your hands. Oh, check the time. 10 seconds left. And that's time. Alright.
Taking a little forward there? Taking a little forward?
Jump squats are next. So, set these off to the side. Don't do jump squats on a mat. It'll just slip out from underneath you. You'll get seriously hurt, probably. Sorry, I'll step up here, yeah. Okay, so the jump squat. Soft landing, jump, and knees out. All right, so it's up and squat down. Ready, and go. So it's up and squat. Just like that. When you're doing it, if you want to swing your arms for a bit more momentum, like this, helps quite a bit. If you're finding the jump is too much underneath, forgot to modify this last time, you're just going to do a regular squat down like this. So John's doing the jump squat and you can do regular. So just go at your own pace, modify as you need to, and progress as you need to, but those are some options. 5 seconds. One more. We went over a little bit, but that's good. The next one is lunges. My shoe is untied. Just give me 1 second to tie this. John will dance for you while I'm tying my shoe. Push off that front foot. All right, ready? Yeah, and go. So down, push off that front foot. I like to keep my hands on my hips, sort of squaring off a little bit. You want to bring that back knee nice and close. And that front knee, making sure it doesn't cave in like this. So when you come down, let me show you again. Close and knee out. Everyone's doing a great job. Keep going. Last one. Nice job. All right, we're going back into the inchworms. Actually, we don't need the mats. So you want to keep those off to the side for the inchworms. So, like I said before, inchworms, you're just going to walk yourself out like this, and then normally you would walk your feet to your hands. We're gonna walk our feet back just so we stay in the camera the whole time. I mean our hands. All right, quiet. And go. Sometimes I don't know why I take him with me. So John's doing the progression. He's doing a push-up with his. If you'd like to modify and just take breaks. Last one, walk your hands out, nice flat back, and we're done. So the next one is, we're done with that one, sorry. The next one is bird dog. Almost there. We got about 10 seconds left. Whew, time for one more. And one more on the opposite side. Extending, touch, and extend. And we are done for time. We're going to do the plank with the arm reach on this one. So we're just in our break, and then we'll go right into it. All right, the plank with the arm reach, like I said before, easier if you start in the low plank and your feet are spaced out a little bit more. Gives you a bit more stability. So it's just like this, down, and reach, and back in. If you're having a little bit of trouble with it, you can have your feet out, and reach just like this. Seconds left. Up, squeeze, slowly lower, and that's time. The last one on our list is pulse squats. So we'll take these mats off to the side. Give me 1 second to give a comment. Sorry, I'm like, hi, Cheryl. Hi, Mom. Hi, Natasha. So many people. All right, so the next one is a pulse squat. So you're gonna have your feet just shoulder width apart. You're gonna come down. Your knees are gonna be pointed outward and you're just gonna pulse. Mom, these are your favorites, so let's get into it. All right, ready? And go. Nice and low, and you're gonna pulse. So you don't want your knees to cave in at all. You want to keep them out to the side, nice and low like this. I'll show you side version. So when you're doing this, you don't want to round your back like this. You want to keep it up nice and straight and knees out. One.
This burns.
It does burn. It burns so good though. If you need to stand up and shake your legs out, you can, and then get right back into it.
Don't do it.
Come on, Cheryl, I know you can do it. And shake them out. If you're finding it hard, you can bring it up a tiny bit in pulse, but try to keep it nice and low. And that's time. Sweet! We got through 2 rounds. Everyone did really good. So we'll go into the cool down. We're going to do a 2-minute break before the cool down. Grab some water and whatever else you need. And then we'll get into it. Okay, you can get your mat back out for the cool down.
Okay.
if anything happens during it. Fill out a, and you're a member, fill out a CF98. And if you're unsure about doing the workout, you can fill out the Get Active Questionnaire and just sort of see where your fitness level is at. I'll link everything in the description when I upload this video. We have one more minute of cool down. I mean of break before the cool down. Into the cool down now. So we'll start standing for this end part. So you're just going to have one hand behind your back like this. And you're going to stretch out your neck to the side. We'll hold that for a few seconds. And then we're just going to switch arms. And same thing on the opposite side. You can give that a little pull. You should feel that in your neck. Next, we'll go into the hamstring. So we're just going to have one foot out in front of us. You're going to pull up on your toes. Try to keep them pointing toward the ceiling. You should feel a nice stretch in the back of your legs. Just the front leg, sorry. We'll switch legs in a second. The next one is the glute, so we're going to hold on to something, or you can do it sitting down. So do you want to do this sitting down? So John's going to show you the lying down glute one, and I will show you the standing. So for the standing, you're just going to have your foot on your quad, you're going to come all the way down, and you're just going to sit, and this is the modified lying down version. You can grab your knee, or you can grab underneath the back of your leg and extend up. And then we're gonna switch sides. You can hold all these stretches a little bit longer when you're at home, if they're feeling good. We're gonna sit down for the next part. So we're gonna do a butterfly stretch. So your feet are going to be together just like this. You're going to hold on to your toes and you're going to bring your knees out to the side. You can pulse your legs up and down just to get a bit more of a stretch if you don't have a lot of flexibility. Make sure your back is nice and straight and you can wiggle your bum in closer to your heels. Stretch. You're going to bring your leg behind you and you can lie all the way back or you can stay up. You can go on one arm or you can lay the whole way back, wherever you get the most stretch that's comfortable. Tension, not pain. Once you're done on that side, you're going to switch. Same thing. Nice. All right, we're going to go into hip flexor. So you're going to be on your knees, one foot out in front of you, just like this. You need to be on the edge of my mat. Right here. You're going to push forward and you should feel it right here, this stretch. So push forward. And we're going to switch. can hold these a little bit longer if you have lots of time at home. So just gonna forward. We're almost done here. We just have a few more stretches and then we'll be done. The calf stretch that we're doing next, it could be a little bit hard to see just because you need a wall for it. You're just gonna put your foot up against the wall just like this, and you're gonna lean into it. So you get that nice stretch in the back. And opposite side, so same thing, your toes are nice and high on the edge of the wall. And just lean into it. Any little ledge that you have for your foot to go on will work. It doesn't need to be a wall or anything. The next one is a standing forward bend. So you're just going to have your hands, you're just going to let yourself bend down and sort of side to side. Just let yourself sway back and forth. Have your hands in front of you. Keep going. I'm going to tie my shoe. And slowly roll up from that. You're gonna go into a tricep. So for this one, you want your hand in the middle of your upper back, just like this. And you're gonna switch, same thing. Into shoulder, we're bringing one hand across. Swing your arms and let your other one come across. And we'll go through these last couple in a bit of a sequence. Down onto your mat. We're going to go into cat-cow. So you're going to start with your back curved. And then we're going to push up and back down, curve, and push up. From here, you're going to extend your legs out, bringing yourself down, and push yourself up off the ground. In a cobra, if it's too high, keep yourself lower. You're going to bring your knees nice and wide to the outside of your mat. You're going to put your feet together and sit back in a child's pose. From here we have two more. We're going to unload our low back. So you're going to lie on your back, grab your knees, and give your back a little bit of a massage. You can go side to side, you can roll around. And extend your arms and legs all the way out. Relax there for a moment. And whenever you're ready, you can slowly get back up. And you are done. If you guys have any questions or anything, please feel free to leave a comment down below. And yeah, happy Victoria Day. And I'll see you next Wednesday. Bye, guys.